Thank you.
Welcome to the final of EuroLeague Women 2023 here in Prague, and what a game we have to close the season out. An all-Turkish affair as Fenerbahce and Mersin go head-to-head for the title. The only thing we know for certain right now is that a new name will be engraved on the trophy, as neither of these teams have got their hands on it before. I'm Mark Mills, I'm joined by former French international player Diondra Chachong. Diondra, blood, sweat, tears, and a whole lot more has gone into this season for both these teams. How excited are you about this final?
I mean, it's going to be great to see already the atmosphere in the gym, in the arena. Fener fans are ready to go. And now it's going to be a great game, especially with Fener wanting to make a statement.
Yeah, absolutely. Two phenomenal teams in front of us tonight. They've worked hard to get to this final four. Fenerbahce beating Skio in the semi-finals, whilst Mersin did the unthinkable and turned over Praha here on their home floor in their semi-final. Earlier today, Skio, well, they completed the fairy tale and picked up the bronze medal with a win over Praha, a buzzer-beating win over Praha. First to be introduced to the crowd here will be Mersin. A phenomenal semi-final as they look to take apart Praha. It was defense on Friday. Is it going to be defense again today, Dion?
For sure, it's going to be defense. It's going to be taking care of the ball against Fenerbahce, a team that loves to run. And we keep saying that there are beginners in this final four, but you have players like Servendakic, Dubljevic, Tiffany Hayes, Coach Ninguez, even Chelsea Gray, that's her first Final Four, but they are used to this kind of moment. They live for this kind of moment, so there won't be no pressure for them, I'm sure. I just feel like the way their season has been, they're really feeling off everything they had to go through, changing players, changing coach. That's really helping them to try to leave a legacy this season with this team of Mersin.
Yeah, there's no two ways about it. The roster that Mersin have under the tutelage and guidance of Coach Ineguez is full of superstars, players that can go toe-to-toe with this all-star lineup that Fenerbahce have bought. It's just that maybe Fenerbahce have a little more depth than Mersin, but you can only have five players on the floor at one time.
Definitely. They have people at every position. They have versatile players like Savandakic, she can play the four, the three. They are really a good team, and he uses also his bench, so they're really well coached.
Now Fenerbahce will be introduced to the crowd here in the arena, and you have to go all the way back to game day three to find the last time they were loose again. They lost their first two games of the season. They're now on an unbelievable 15 winning streak. How important for Fenerbahce, though, is getting a good start today, because they didn't in the semi-final?
Yeah, they haven't in the semi-final. It was a tough first half for them against Kyo. But I feel like now at least they know what they have to do. Defense, that's the only one. I was asking Coach Markovic at halftime what was missing, and he said just one word, defense. And we saw when they came back in the second half and they raised the intensity in defense, that was a different game. And honestly, when they get steals, when they get good rebounds, and when they run, they're kind of unstoppable. So that's what we want to see from them tonight, obviously.
Yeah, an unbelievable roster brought together by Fenerbahce this year. They're clearly on the redemption road, trying to make up for that loss on their home floor last year. Can they complete that redemption? There is a big obstacle in their way in the shape of fellow Turkish team Mersin. We are set for an amazing 40 minutes of basketball to close out our EuroLeague women's season. The arena is full, the crowd are loud, and we are ready here in the commentary box for this one. We are more than ready. The build-up this week has got us excited for what should be an unbelievable way to close out our season. The players go to the half court, but that is what it is all about. That is what we are here for, that beautiful, beautiful trophy that both these teams, both these clubs want to get their hands on for the first time in their respective histories. There are the Fenerbahce fans. They bring the party wherever they go. Here's our starting five for Mersin. Cornelius, Gray, Hayes, Servan Dakic and Williams. Wow, that is a tough starting five. So much offensive firepower, and then you have the rim protection of Elizabeth Williams to sit behind that.
Yeah, Elizabeth Williams, she was just a blocking monster. Like, she had like five blocks in that game. It was really tough for Prague to get in that paint on Friday night, and she'll probably do the same today.
And Coach Inagez, I'm sure that's what he'll be talking about with his team. Build it from defense. Get good defensive structure in place and then build from there. That's where they're going to be able to upset Fenerbahce. Fenerbahce struggle to get their offense firing. Their confidence will dip. Here are our officials for today's final. Andrus Antrojas, Viola Georgi and Gatis Salins from Latvia, Romania and Latvia respectively. The officiating crew are ready to get to it for this game. Starting five now for Fenerbahce. Olcay Çakar, the captain. Kayla McBride, Alina Yagapova, Brianna Stewart, and our newly crowned MVP, Emma Messerman. What a starting five, and how much talent coming off the bench for Coach Malkovic. Sabali, Van der Sloot, Stokes, you name it, there is a whole host of talent for her to work with.
Yeah, like we said on Friday, the five on the bench could be actually the five on the to start the game. It doesn't make any difference for that team, and that's the team with the most depth that we've seen in the Final Four, and for sure they will use it. And Coach Malkovic knows what she's doing when she keeps Van der Sloot and Sabali on the bench.
And it's interesting as well, because we saw the rotations in the semi-final, and it took Coach Malkovic a bit of time to find the five that were going to do the most damage. Let's have a look at our head-to-head, though. We have Servan Dakic as one of our players going up against Brianna Stewart. Not sure how often they'll face each other on the floor, but they truly are going to be two huge players for their respective teams tonight.
Yeah, two great players. Servan Dakic, she's used to those moments, like I was saying. She's one of the top players in the league for a little while now. And I think she's bringing that extra boost for Mersin when she came late in the season. And Brianna Stewart, one of the best players in the world, simply. She had a double-double, but we could see she was frustrated with her shooting percentage in the semi-final, and for sure, even if it looked like a good game for us, I'm sure she will want to get bounce back and get a better shooting percentage to help her team up Fenerbahce.
Yeah, it tells you the caliber of a player. Her semi-final performance was 24 points, 11 rebounds and 3 blocks, and she wasn't happy.
Yeah, she wasn't happy.
That tells you all you need to know about her as a competitor.
Yeah.
That was the trophy. That's what we're here for. Who will be lifting it, though? If the third place playoff is anything to go by, please strap yourselves in, because we are in for a roller coaster of 40 minutes of basketball as these two teams look to go at it for the win. Just a reminder, with a little over a minute until tip-off, if you have your phones to hand, please do download the EuroLeague Women app, available on Android and iOS. You'll be able to follow the stats real-time. You'll also be able to jump into the press conference after the game and a ton of highlights and everything you could ever want. And if you do feel so as well, please do jump onto social media. Use hashtag EuroLeague Women, and that will get you into the conversation. What are the keys for today's game then, DeAndre? What is going to be the deciding factor for this one?
I think if you look at it from Mersin, for sure you have to take care of the ball. Fenerbahce is scoring 24 points from the turnovers, 20 points in the fast break. They just love to run, and giving them easier to feed it is not good. And obviously, contain Van der Sloot. She had 11 assists in the semi-final. And for Fenerbahce, it's going to be to try to limit Chelsea Gray. She had 9 assists, crazy assists that we're here to witness. And I think if you Fenerbahce, one thing they did good in the semi-final when they couldn't find a way to score, when they put Sabali at the three position, that makes a huge difference, and they could use that mismatch at some point in the game, I'm sure.
Yeah, there's some really interesting kind of different matchups that you're going to see the coaches put together, and Coach Malkovic and Coach Inagez, they will play their part in today's game. Make no mistake, the coaches, the way they react to the in-game behavior and action will absolutely have a huge impact on today's game. They both have wonderful rosters, stuff full of superstars, but how they use them and when they use them will be the game changer. And we are underway here in Prague, the opening tip of the EuroLeague Women 2023 final, as Fenerbahce and Mersin both in the hunt for their first titles. Gray now, the double team comes across, Chaka throws herself to the floor, Yagapova scoops up the loose ball but will bring it back out.
And we saw from the first offense they're playing strong on the peaks, on a Chelsea Gray. They want her to pass the ball, they don't want her to be able to attack.
Servan Dakic now hands it back to Cornelius. Patience here from Mersin as they let the offense set itself. A little shoulder fake from Servan Dakic. Oh, with the spin, what an opening move.
Nice move.
And straight away, Fener looking to run the pace. Transition will be Fenerbahce's friend. They have the depth of roster to keep pushing for the entire 40 minutes. Chaka for two, nails it this time. A quick stop in the play for her to tie her shoelaces, but that will be a nice nerve settler for Fenerbahce.
That's the best. We see that move from Kevin Dakic, really good, and that's the best answer for Shakir. They go under the screen, she has to punish them and take that shot.
Yeah, absolutely. They dropped off and they showed her no respect. And as a player, you have to demand that respect in this game. Otherwise, you don't have the right to be on the floor. You almost become a liability on the offensive end. So that was smart from Chaka to step up to the plate and take the shot. It's on the floor again. Bodies flying everywhere. But once again, Fenerbahce come away with possession. Chaka drives inside, has it stripped, but the foul will be called, I think, on Hayes. Coach Inegez claiming it was all ball. The official disagrees with that one. Fenerbahce fans have started early. Let's have a look at the replay. Tough to see from that camera angle whether it was a foul or not. Well, that's a pass that's tough for McBride. It's thrown inside to Cornelius. Gray will look to set it up. Servan Dakic. Oh, nails it off the glass. She's asking for the foul, and I think she should be rather grateful that that one dropped.
She came ready.
Servan Dakic is going head to head with Stewart right now, and Stewart throws up the old school skyhook. It rattles out of bounds though, and will be Mersin ball on the baseline. You have to love the tempo that this game has started at. There's no kind of feeling out the game, finding their way in. They're full pelt, straight away, 100% on the floor.
Yep. Already very intense from both teams.
Hayes now uses the Williams screen, comes back on it again.
Yes.
Slides past Messerman, and that's a smart play by Hayes. Uses a little quick first step to get past the big. 5-point lead for Mersin within the first 2.5 minutes. Stewart for three, nails it. Brianna Stewart looks locked in. No emotion, she is here to do a job, and that's to win the title. Hayes returns the favor, this time short though. Yagapova with the rebound. Little shake, tries to blast past Cornelius, but hands it off to Messerman. Messerman will get the score, and Yagapova once again, the magician with the creative dish.
Great look. Every time she's going to attack, everybody's going to try to close the paint, and she finds who's open.
Servan Dakic now reverses out, backs up against Messerman, fancies her footwork against the big. Messerman's defense is more than a match, though, in that exchange. Inside to Stewart. Oh, misses the easy layup. Messerman will go back though and scoop up the rebound. She doesn't get it to go either. And Stewie struggled at times in that semi-final to get that soft touch around the rim.
And that's smart to send Stewart in the post-up. She has Servan Dakic guarding her.
Oh, Cornelius, corner pocket three is good. Mersin reopen a 3-point lead with that make. Two very offensive-minded teams going toe-to-toe at the moment. Stewart with the mid-range, a little heavy. Messerman with another rebound, her third of the game already.
She's open again.
Olcay Çakır there not taking the opportunity. Foul's going to be called, I think, on Servan Dakic, trying to jump around the screen. As Hayes easily makes her way past Messerman for the score that time, but there's the pass from Yagapova. And Messerman and Yagapova, not a lot's talked about that little pairing, but it certainly produced an awful lot throughout the season for Fenerbahce. Inbounded to McBride. McBride goes strong, and it's an unusual play from Fenerbahce. They don't usually roll McBride to the rim like that, but it pays off this time.
Execution was perfect.
Gray now draws the double team. It goes to Williams, but Stewart reads the passing lane well, and you can see straight away Fenerbahce jumped to the double team as soon as Gray touches the ball. Stewie, oh, mid-range two. Brianna Stewart.
We said it before the game, but every time Fenerbahce receives the ball, most of the time it's 2 points, 3 points or foul at least. Yes. You want to take care of the ball.
Stewie bringing the ball all the way up the floor, and Servan Dakic giving her way too much space to take the jumper, also drawing the foul. That will see Servan Dakic head to the bench with her second foul already. That is a problem. She is one of the most influential players on the floor. Dublovic has come in her place for Coach Iniguez. A little bit of full court pressure here from Fenerbahce. Foul will be called on Yagapova. First foul of the game for Fenerbahce.
That's a good foul.
That is an interesting matchup between Yagapova and Hayes. Yagapova clearly the stronger of the two. Hayes will probably beat her in a foot race, but which is going to be the more important today, we yet to see. Cornelius uses the Williams screen. The double team comes up onto Cornelius, though. Williams now against Messerman. Messerman just jumps in for the ball. Rips it away. Çakır initiating the transition. Good defense by Dubljevic, though. She closed off the lane.
They've
got the mismatch. Stewart now. Is she going to get possession? She is, but they've been able to swap. But Çakır is open. Oh, lovely. Finds a way through. Olcay Çakır up to 4 points early in this game, and Fenerbahce's lead is out to four. Hayes left open for the three. High arcing, and the Orange Iron springs that one away. McBride, quick release but short. She bats it back to Messerman. And smart play by McBride.
Another rebound for Fenerbahce.
Oh, the handoff from Yagapova was telegraphed, and Gray was there to steal it away. She's going to go all the way. Pulls up short, two is good. And that will settle some nerves for Chelsea Gray, her first score of the game. And if Mersin are going to come away with the trophy, you feel that Gray is going to be one of the most important parts of that puzzle.
Definitely.
Cornelius called for the foul. That's her first.
I feel like Mersin hasn't been able to find the inside players yet, like they did in the semi-final with Williams, who was really effective in offense. That's probably what's missing a little bit right now for them. But like you said, for sure, Chelsea Gray, you want to be able to count on her if you want to win this game.
Like you say, Gray was so effective in that semi-final because she was finding passing lanes into the bigs. As we see Van der Sloot come into the game for Yagapova. And straight away, Sloot does what Sloot does best. Gets to the bucket and gets an easy score.
Best way to start the game for her.
As you say, her stat line almost crept under the radar in the semi-final, and then you looked at it at the end and you were like, that's almost a career stat line for most players. Ljubic no good. Rebound pulled down by Messerman. Fourth rebound of the game for this year's MVP. Stewart, another three ball goes up. Oh, she hits it, draws the foul. She'll head to the free throw line for the chance of a 4-point play.
I mean, that's the type of day she's in. It's going to be difficult.
And it's interesting with Brianna Stewart and all of the build-up as we see the replay of her hitting that three and drawing the contact. She's talked about, we want to write our story. It's not about previous years and the history and the disappointment. We are here as a team to write our story this year. And you can see from the way she's playing, that's how she's approaching this game.
Not affected at all by the past past history of Fenerbahce. Like she said, they are here to make their own story. And that's beautiful, and we see it.
Timeout called by Coach Iniguez as Brianna Stewart making that free throw takes herself out to double digits. We're going to jump straight into the Mersin huddle and hear what Coach has to say.
This is very low. Take care, two must help there with the Stewart when she's in 45. Yeah, two must help to the ball. We have to help here to recover. Short the space. We are late there. Okay, Alice and you. Okay, if they play here corner, okay, this player, when they play the pick and roll, expanding here and recover. Yes. Okay, let's take care of this. Vamos! We go now. One down. One down and four sides. Chelsea. Okay, and we can use left, Tiffany.
Take the ball out of
money. One down, four sides, and get for Tiffany. This 3 minutes. So we got bonus. Okay.
Really, Coach Iniguez left with no choice. His team trails by eight, and there's still over 3 minutes left in his first quarter. What was he trying to achieve with that timeout, do you think?
I'm sure he wants to calm his team down, especially with Stewart going crazy already with 10 points. You know, when the game go fast like that, you just in the rhythm that's not yours. You don't have to want to be at the rhythm of Fenerbahce. You have to have your own rhythm, and that's how they got here at Mersin. So they need to try to dictate the tempo a little more.
Oh, and Hayes has taken a shot to the eye as the double team from Van der Sloot and Chaka was lightning quick to try and lock her into Coffin Corner. It will be a sideline possession, though, for Mersin. Fenerbahce, relentless is the probably the DNA that Coach Malkovic is asking for now.
Yeah. Every time she serves one, the intensity has to stay as high.
Gray now at the top, waits for the screen. Patience here from Mersin. Gray inside, little step back, lovely handle, pulls up, two ball, rattles out though. Foul's going to be called. Who's that on? Foul will be called on Messerman. Her first of the game. Only the third team foul of the quarter for Fenerbahce though, so it will be a sideline possession. Yeah, and it was really before the rebound. She was trying to lock Williams out of the game with her hands.
Way to be aggressive for Elizabeth Williams on the rebound, because like we said, we used to see her on the defensive role, but she's much more of an offensive player this season. And that's what we want to see, like we see that on Friday against Prague.
Double change for Fenerbahce as Onar and Stokes comes in for Van der Sloot and Messerman. Knocked out of bounds by McBride. Good quick hands, and Fenerbahce now look like they're almost doubling everything. They're trying to jump on every single opportunity to steal the ball.
That's really like Marina Malkovic defense, for sure. Double team, sometimes triple team.
Hayes tries to bully her way through. What's the call? It's a late call, but the official says foul. Wait to see who that's on. Is it on Chaka or Stewart?
That was,
I think it's on Chaka.
That's what my Mersin has to do. Attack the basket and draw fouls.
Yeah, it's the first to drop. 81% free throw shooter, Tiffany Hayes. Had 19 points in the semi-final. Onar now waits for the offense to start into the hands of Stewart. Stewart, another three. Oh my goodness. When Brianna Stewart is this hot from downtown, it is a tough, tough assignment. Brianna Stewart already up to 13 points.
8 minutes.
Are we in for one of those nights that goes down in the history books from Brianna Stewart? It's starting that way. Dubljevic against Chaka, tries to get through the defense, draws the foul, doesn't get the and one, but will earn herself a trip to the free throw line. And Jelena Dubljevic, the veteran, did the job in the semi-final. She came in, she was aggressive, she was high tempo, and she's trying to do the same again here today.
Yeah, we said that Mersin team is not the most experienced, so you need players like her to step up and show the right example. And we saw again that Fenerbahce came to double. She wasn't even in the paint, but they're really pressuring them. She was outside the paint, but Brianna Stewart came and helped her teammate in the mismatch.
Chaka called for her second foul on that one, and Aydin, I think, is going to come in her place. Not at the moment, yeah. Dubljevic back at the line for the second. Rattles home the second and brings it down to an 8-point ball game. 2 minutes and 5 seconds left in this first quarter. Onar now picks up point guard responsibilities with Fenerbahce's captain on the bench with two fouls. Inside to Stewart. She can shoot the three ball. Let's see her post game. There's her post game. There are no weaknesses in Brianna Stewart's game right now.
She's just unstoppable right now. And Fenerbahce without Shakir and Van der Sloot on the court.
Gray hands it off to Hayes. Neither Gray nor Hayes have had the impact they will have wanted just yet. Blocking foul's going to be called on Onar. A real mismatch as she was left guarding Williams deep down in the paint. Not a matchup that Onar will have wanted. Let's have a look. Yeah, there's the mismatch, and really Onar just getting in the way of Williams. Both teams in the penalty now, so Williams will head to the free throw line. Just a 50% free throw shooter this season though, Elizabeth Williams.
And we've seen that mismatch, Fenerbahce wants to switch and they're impacted. Like Shakir just before made a foul on the mismatch with Dubljevic now. It's on our with Elizabeth Williams. They need to find out more.
Yeah, it's interesting, isn't it? They're almost switching all the way, one through five. Everyone switch on every screen, and it will cause them fouls, but they have maybe the depth to deal with it. So we'll see if they continue to do that. But it's an interesting strategy from Coach Malkovic just to keep the defense so high tempo by doing that.
Talking of depth, Satu Savali still hasn't made her way in the game. That tells us how much depth they have.
Aydin for three. Not this time. Williams reaches up high and taps it back to Hayes. Hayes so keen to get into the game. She goes coast to coast. Doesn't get the roll though. Williams is there to scoop up the rebound. Second board of the night for Williams, but a rejection by Stokes. Elizabeth Williams receiving a little bit of her own medicine that time. Onar initiating the offense now into the hands of Stewart. Quick release and an easy string music too for Brianna Stewart. 17 points.
Just one of these nights.
We are witnessing true greatness here in this first quarter. A 17-point first quarter in a final for Brianna Stewart. Gray behind the back. Fades away along the baseline. Oh my goodness. I'm not sure there's many players on the planet that could nail that shot in a final. Chelsea Gray is one of them. Oh no, draws contact. Can't get the score though. Fenerbahce look the most confident I think I may have seen them all season. And if you're Coach Inegez or Mersin, that is terrifying to see an ultra-confident Fenerbahce on the floor. There's the block from Stokes, and then the tough defense. She just bodies her. There's the block, my goodness.
Coach Malkovic was saying how they don't care about the pressure and how they live with it. And you're really seeing that tonight. They're having a perfect start.
hits both from the free throw line, up to 29 points. 4.9 seconds left in this first quarter. Pass to Hayes. She's got the jets to get up the floor. Puts the three up, and it's going to come up short. And that is an absolute storybook start for Fenerbahce. 10 minutes of the final already completed, and Fenerbahce lead this one 29-17 over Mersin. What a first quarter for Fenerbahce. Look at those shooting percentages. That is a coach's dream start to a final. As for Mersin, they're not shooting awfully. Two-point percentage, not great, but it's Fenerbahce that are dictating the entire flow of this game.
Yeah, they're really closing the paint. I think Fenerbahce is really closing the paint. They double everything. Every time there's a mismatch or a post-up from Mersin, they make sure that they don't get anything easy. And for me, that's the biggest difference. Mersin is not having a bad game. It's just a great defense by Fenerbahce.
Yeah, it's kind of the way it is. Fenerbahce absolutely came a lot more focused. We were watching their warm-up, and I didn't feel the nerves this time. I didn't feel like they were a little bit scared of the situation. I felt like that maybe they've got that out of their system in the first half of the semi-final, and they seemed a lot more business-like in their warm-up today.
Yeah, I mean, they've been waiting for this moment all season, and probably tired of people reminding them that they haven't won yet, so want to make sure they're going to do it this time.
And for Mersin, for Coach Iniguez, what's that message in that quarter huddle? What's the main thing? There's lots of things that he might want to change, but what would be the one thing that he'd want them to focus in on?
I think for sure, I mean, she's one of the best players of the world for sure, but you need to limit her. 17 points in one quarter, that's too much. And they need to find a way to be more physical with her, make her touch is hard. She's getting the ball, she's having the ball in her hand, and right now they really need to limit her, otherwise it's going to be a long night for them.
Could we even see the elusive box and one come out against Brianna Stewart and just try and lock her out of the game? Clearly, Fenerbahce have plenty of other offensive firepower that would pick you apart if you did that, but there's a point where you say we just need to take Stewie out of the game for a while to see if the rest of the team can step up and carry that weight.
Yeah, obviously you know they can, but in that chemistry right now, it's her that you want to stop.
So at the moment, at the end of the first quarter, it's Brianna Stewart 17, Mersin 17. Second quarter underway here in Prague of the 2023 EuroLeague Women Final. With 10 minutes completed, Fenerbahce firmly in the driving seat. They lead this one 29-17 over Mersin. McBride comes back out.
Sadali has met her way into the game.
Super aggressive work from Hollingsworth. Long rebound falls to Stewart. Second rebound of the game. Sabaly now with this first taste of possession. Working hard in the low post. Sabaly and Dubljevic having a wrestling match, but it matters not because Brianna Stewart just drains another three, and a wry smile creeps across her face. She's feeling it tonight.
Coach Ninguez calling back Savenda Kic. Try to take care of Brianna Stewart.
Yeah, Brianna Stewart now has more points than Mersin do as a team. Great crossover. McBride stays with it though, and Gray's forced to almost chuck the shot up. It wasn't her usual form. Long pass to Stewart. Oh, Stewart catches it, but it's knocked to the floor.
That's a great pass. Good look.
That's a great pass. It's more like a wide receiver move from Stewart than a basketball move. Over her shoulder, and Dubljevic knocks her to the floor, but Stewart holds on to it in the end zone. Touchdown for Brianna Stewart. She'll head back. It'll be a sideline possession. Fenerbahce just look absolutely on another level right now. Servan Dakic comes back into the game. And you kind of think, you look, yes, she's on two fouls, but what are you saving the fouls for? And in fact, an unsportsmanlike foul has been called on Jelena Dubljevic for the foul on Stewart. And I don't think there was any malice in that foul. It was just more clumsy than anything else. So Stewart will head to the line for two free throws, and they will take possession back as well. It's the first of her two. This is unreal. 22 points for Brianna Stewart, 7 from 10 from the field. She's been on the floor 11 minutes and 8 seconds.
Yeah, it's already been a 17 points margin.
This is one of those games where you're going to remember where you were when Brianna Stewart went off in a EuroLeague women's final. Onar looking to feed Stewart. Stewart having to re-establish against Servan Dakic. Stewart gets it away and rattles it home. My goodness me, I think she should close her eyes and throw it and it would still go down tonight.
That's ridiculous. 24 points.
Servan Dakic hands it to Gray. Foul's going to be called on Stokes. She went to the hedge, but she hedged with her hands instead of her feet. And that will be a foul. First foul of the quarter on Fenerbahce. They lead by 19 points. Brianna Stewart heads to the bench. She gives, I think, Coach Malkovich a wry smile saying, please don't take me off. I'm absolutely flying right now. Let me just keep going until the hot hand runs out. Brianna Stewart, a legend of the game before tonight and a legendary status, just goes from strength to strength. And an offensive foul is called, I think, on Hollingsworth for an illegal screen against Onar. Coach Iniguez protesting his team's innocence. And a salute now to Onar. McBride working so hard to try and find space to shoot, and Hayes tracking her all over the floor.
So fast.
Sloop for three, off left. Hollingsworth slides through the paint to secure the rebound. Servan Dakic now. Gray now playing almost as a two guard rather than the point guard that she is labelled. Oh, lovely pass around the corner, but Hollingsworth can't hold on to it. What's the call? Wait to see what the call is from the official there. As we're going to see Yagapova come back into the action, and you'd almost forgotten about the little thing that is one of the all-time greats, Yagapova, sitting on the bench waiting to get her turn. We also forget, though, at the moment, the current EuroLeague Women's MVP has been sat on the bench for much of the game.
Yeah, Brianna Stewart and Mamas been on the bench.
Hayes fakes it, drives inside. That was a tough play up against McBride, but Hollingsworth is there for the offensive rebound. Where is it now? It's with Sabali. She brings it up over the half. The unicorn going up against Servan Dakic. Out to McBride. Where's the call of the foul?
Another foul for Hollingsworth.
Another one on Hollingsworth. In fact, that's just her first. It is the third team foul of the quarter, and there's still 7 minutes and 22 seconds left in this quarter. You know, Hollingsworth just running through Sabali. And you're seeing some frustration now from the Mersin coach and the players, and it's understandable. I don't particularly think there's anything for them to be overly frustrated about, although it has been called as a technical foul on the bench. So there will be a technical free throw for Kayla McBride.
They need to be careful. They already done 19. That's the second technical foul. They really need to take care of those opportunities.
They're still in this game. As crazy as it sounds, down 19, you'd rather have this scoreline this early in the game. Yeah. It gives you time to fight your way back in. Yeah. We saw it in the third place game. You know, we saw Praha battle from 13 down to tie the game and almost win it right in the final stages. For Mersin now, discipline is key, right?
They need to stay poised and of course they need to not want to go back in the game by playing by themselves. Right now we see a lot of one-on-one actions, one against two, one against three, and that's not what you want to do. You want to build play by play and team play. That's what they did really well on Friday, and that's what they need to do now.
Yeah, Coach Iniguez has been preaching it throughout the build-up to these Final Fours about how they've got here and how they want to continue to play that way. And that's how they'll be successful. In the moment, I think you're right. I think they've kind of abandoned it, and players are a little bit caught in the headlights and are trying to get their team back into the game on their own. Okay, we are now ready for the technical free throw, which Caleb McBride will take. And McBride hits the bonus. A 21-point lead now for Fenerbahce. Sorry, a 20-point lead for Fenerbahce. As we see Williams come back into the game. To the bench heads Hollingsworth. Officials just clarifying something at the moment. It will be a baseline ball for Fenerbahce. Just a little confusion on the officials table. The referee's now going over to sort that out. Fenerbahce fans have been given plenty to sing about by Coach Malkovic and her team. Coach Malkovic, though, one of those coaches that will never stop. She could be up by 50, she will still be asking for more and more and more from her team.
She always has that secret ingredient coming out of nowhere, so you can be sure she'll be there.
Jakubova, little fade back, too much of a fade back here. Stokes keeps it alive. McBride for three. First bit of space she's had, can't get the score though. Servan Dakic now uses the screen by Williams. Little shake, little fake, but the defense stays with her. Foul's going to be called. Jakubova just taunted into trying to rip that one away, but she catches the arm of the Serbian.
Fenerbahce defense is just premium right now because Kremendek had no solution again.
And it's the off-ball defense. There's just no passing lanes for Mersin to work with at all. You watch this play now and they're closing out passing lanes. They're doubling where they
doubling
can.
Doubling again.
Hayes now steps through, throws the prayer pass out to Cornelia. Shot clock to four. Servan Dakic has to throw it with a heave and it's a long rebound into the hands of Vandersloot.
Everything is difficult.
Jakubova muscles away to the basket. Offensive foul will be called on Alina Jakubova as Hayes takes the stand. Let's have a look at the replay of this one. And yeah, I think Jakubova probably just leaned in a little bit too much. I think Hayes was moving, but she was trying to retreat.
Yeah, with her elbow maybe.
Yeah, extension of the arm probably cost Jakubova the call. Jakubova heads to the bench because that's her third foul. A slight glimmer of hope when Fenerbahce's key players start picking up foul trouble, but into the game comes Brianna Stewart. Score for Williams. Can Brianna Stewart pick up where she left off? Just a reminder of where she left off. She left off with 24 points. And a Sloot short two, too short. And Mersin starting to find a little momentum with 6 minutes left in the half. Hayes now looks to go along the baseline past Sabali. Good help across by Stokes. Hayes is left on the floor in a heap. Fenerbahce have the 5-on-4 advantage. Van der Sloot hits the three ball and now the game will be stopped. As Tiffany Hayes is still on the floor on Fenerbahce's free throw line. Holding her knee by the looks of it. Need to see a replay on that one. The medical team are on the floor to deal with her. As Coach Iniguez wants to have a conversation with the officials. Is it her chest? Maybe it is. Yeah, she looks like she might be having some trouble breathing. Maybe something with the ribs. The worst bit for me, out come the smelling salts. That will wake you up for sure. Let's have a look at the replay. And she runs straight into Stokes. And maybe it just was the force of contact.
The shug.
Yeah, probably was. Just a rocked against her ribs. She's being helped to her feet. Hopefully we'll see her back on the floor, because with Mersin trailing by 21 points right now, the last thing they need is to lose one of their absolute leaders on the floor. She's being helped off the baseline. We'll see further attention from the medical team. In her place will come Chelsea Gray, and that will change up Coach Iniguez's rotations. As we see Yagapova stricken to the bench with three fouls. Tiffany Hayes at the other end of the floor just trying to catch her breath. A little winded right now.
Definitely the shocker. These dogs.
And we are back underway. Gray with possession. Simon Dakic hands it back to Gray. Gray with a crossover, pulls up for the long two. Good defense by Stewart. Van der Sloot starts the transition. McBride to Sabali. Oh, it's a thing of beauty. Fenerbahce's transition is poetry in motion.
It's one of the beautiful basketball we've seen all weekend.
Absolutely beautiful basketball. Exactly the way the game's meant to be played. And Fenerbahce are putting on a show here in Prague in the final. Timeout's been called by Coach Iniguez. Let's head into his huddle. Needed timeout for Coach Iniguez. His team at the moment are on the edge of the cliff. He's trying to keep them on the right side of things. How can he do that?
He's trying to find solution. Obviously they're going to change their defense on every mad basketball. They will go into a full court press, and then they will go into a zone 2-3. They have to change something if they want to come back in this game.
Yeah, right now you're trying to pull as many tricks out of the hat as you can. Coach Iniguez reaching deep into his years and years and years of experience at the highest level, trying to find a way to overcome what has been an absolutely amazing first 15 minutes of Fenerbahce in the final. Gray now uses the Williams screen. Cornelia skips it all the way to the corner. Shot goes up and it's good. That's a big shot from Attash. She came on in the semi-final and provided a little bit of a spark, a little bit of a trigger for Mersin when they started losing their energy. Sabali, long two. Where's the rebound? Stewie with the rebound. McBride inside, off the glass, gets her own offensive rebound. Fenerbahce will go again. Landa Sloot into the corner, McBride, quickest of releases. And the smile, look at the celebration, McBride's loving it.
She needed this. She had a tough game on Friday, and she needed to make her first 3 points.
Cornelius to Williams. Attash again for three, rattles away this time. Stewart grabs the rebound, her fourth rebound of the game. And we're going to see the foul called. There's the skip pass to Attash for the three. And there's the quickest gun in the West, Kayla McBride. That release is, if we didn't have slow-mo video, I'm not sure we'd get a replay of Kayla McBride shooting threes. Kia Stokes heads to the bench after putting in an amazing shift. Back in comes Emma Messerman. She's had plenty of rest. Has it batted away though, but Sabali scoops up the loose ball. Stewart now inside Messerman. Oh, beautiful offense by Messerman, all in the footwork, seals out her defender, rolls to the basket for the easiest of scores. ...25 point lead 3.5 minutes still left in this first half. Gray now trying to fight against McBride. Double team comes over, the behind the back is out of bounds from Kelsey Gray, and she is doing all she can.
Everything is difficult right now for Mersin. But they need to play together. They're trying to save the game on the individual actions, and they really need to play more as a team.
Yeah, the pressure that Fenerbahce put them under has certainly shown the cracks in Mersin's team play so far today. McBride, another three. Oh my goodness, string music for Kayla McBride.
They're doing a kind of a matchup zone, but that leaves the shooter open, and you don't want that against Fenerbahce.
Not when you've got Kayla McBride having just hit her first three.
Kayla McBride, yeah.
That's the warning sign that you need to listen to. That's a poor pass by Aitash, and Fenerbahce, the yellow wave, comes crashing down the court. Look at this play. Just take a moment to enjoy what we are witnessing here right now. Look at the swagger from Kayla McBride.
He said, yes, we said it Friday. If she makes one, it could be a long night. And it's starting to look like it.
My goodness me. This game is definitely going to be favorited on YouTube. There's no two ways about it for me. If I'm ever needing a bit of basketball inspiration, I'm going to watch the first 18 minutes of this game, if not more. Look at the play. Messerman with the score there, and it's just relentless. Look at the ball movement here, and Kayla McBride just standing there. You can almost see her mouth watering as the ball's being whipped around, because she knows what's happening. It's going to come to her, and she's going to be wide open for the three.
The way they share the basketball is something to show every kid.
Cornelius now. It's inside, hands it back to Hayes. Hayes back on the floor. That's good to see. The injury wasn't too bad. She goes inside, pulls up short, but comes up short with the shot. Servan Dakic now. Oh, lovely little pivot move.
It's really difficult. Everything from Mersin is just individual actions.
And a sloop inside to Stewart. Foul's going to be called, I think, on Aitash, who just kind of pulled Stewie off the baseline. And once again, Brianna Stewart looking more like a wide receiver than a basketball player at the moment. Maybe she's trying to get a second career underway.
Just can do it all.
Stewart will go to the line for two shots. Both teams now in the penalty. 1 minute 44 left on this first half clock. And it's been breathtaking basketball from Fenerbahce. For me, this Fenerbahce roster and this first half just shows that they truly are one of the greatest teams on the planet from any competition. Into the game comes Onar, to the bench comes Van der Sloot, and you can see how relaxed that Fenerbahce bench is now. They are dancing along with the fans. Brianna Stewart, beautiful footwork, gets in front of the defense. Forces the turnover in the end, and Dubljevic has got to be careful. They're starting to lose their temper now, and it will just end with another unsportsmanlike foul. And Dubljevic already has one. One more and she's out of the game. She'll be sent back to the locker room,
really,
so she needs to be careful.
Really don't need that right now. And you know what's crazy is that Fenerbahce is up 33 points, but they keep putting that full court pressure. They're not done. They just want to go again, again, and again.
McBride back at the free throw line now. And McBride has really picked up where Brianna Stewart left off. McBride now up to 13 points alongside 5 rebounds and 3 assists. And this is the last thing that Mersin will have wanted. They will have wanted this to be close. They will have wanted the pressure to be piled onto Fenerbahce. But right now, Fenerbahce are feeling no pressure whatsoever. They are feeling free to play the basketball they want to play.
Both sides of the court, they have held them to 22 points. 19 minutes, that's huge on both sides of the court.
Cornelius now hands it off to Hayes, and Hayes drops it out of bounds. And anything that could go wrong for Mersin in this first half pretty much has gone wrong. And you can put a lot of that to Mersin themselves, but you also have to say, like you say, the game that Fenerbahce have played, really has left no space for Mersin to breathe at all. Sabali for three. The iron spits that one away to Servandakic to pick up. And is there a player in this Mersin roster that can spark a resurgence, can try and get their team back into this game? Dubljevic, nice fake, drives inside, draws the foul. I think that one will be on Stokes, potentially McBride.
Good take from Dubljevic, good fake.
Let's have a look. Yeah, Kayla McBride picks up her first foul. 52.4 seconds left in this first half. A whirlwind first half, which has been with the blue and yellow stripes all the way. Fenerbahce putting on an absolute lesson, giving us a classic performance in the final. Dubljevic hits the first of her two. An 80% free throw shooter, and so much experience for Joanna Dubljevic. Former WNBA champion. She's won Euro Cup women's tournament as well with Galatasaray. So she brings plenty to the floor for Mersin, but she's going to have to keep a level head and try and help her team's composure in the second half. Sabali to McBride. Hayes closes out the shot this time. Stewart now pulls the trigger on a long two, comes up short, just takes a coat of paint off the iron. Hayes now with 19 seconds left on the first half clock. Servandakic, nice pass inside. Williams can't hold on to it though, so it'll be another turnover. Fenerbahce will probably look to take the final shot of this half. 14.6 seconds. They have scored 57 points in under 20 minutes of basketball whilst holding their opponents to just 24. It truly is a half that will be remembered for a very, very long time. Onar inside, fakes it, tries to skip through, ends up hitting Servandakic in the face, but the rebound comes down to Stokes, but that will be the end of the first half of this final. And what a first half we've had for Fenerbahce. It is all one-way traffic here in Prague, as Fenerbahce take a big step forward towards potentially their first ever EuroLeague Women title. This is a play of the last seconds of that first half. Onar just catching Servandakic in the face, but either way, the Fenerbahce fans are happy. They're in good voice. Half-time score is Fenerbahce 57, Mersin 24. Here are the shooting statistics from that first half, and my goodness me, 48% from two, 62% from three, and 11 from 11 from the free throw line. That is a stat line of dreams for a head coach, and I'm sure Coach Malkovic probably doesn't have much to say. I doubt it. I'm sure Coach Malkovic can find something that she wants to be better. But they have dominated almost every statistical category across the box score with some huge performances from some real key players. None more so than Brianna Stewart. What a first half she's had here in the final. A real statement from Fenerbahce. But the halftime score here in Prague in the final is 57 to Fenerbahce, 24 to Mersin. We'll leave you with some of the highlights from the first half, but don't go anywhere. An exciting second half is just around the corner.
Coach, it's been a difficult first half for your player. What did you tell them?
We have to play. We have to keep playing. Responsibility of the coach. I want they don't give up, and they have to be quiet. Okay, calm down. It's my responsibility. Now I want they show they can play much better than this. You know, of course we know Fener rotation, energy of Fener, how they are playing, the way they play. But we knew that. We knew before.
Thank you, coach. Thank you. Marina, it's been the perfect start for your team. Is there anything you ask them to do better?
Of course, everything. Seriously, 20 minutes only. We have 20 minutes to play half of the game, so nothing's done, absolutely.
Thank you, Marina.
Welcome back to Prague, and welcome back for the second half of this year's EuroLeague Women Final. We have 20 minutes already gone, and my goodness me, what a 20 minutes we've had. One that will go down in the history books, as Fenerbahce have shown us one of the best 20 minutes of basketball I think I may have ever seen. At the half, Fenerbahce lead this one 57-24 over Mersin. Two standout players offensively for Fenerbahce. Brianna Stewart, everything she touches turns to gold today. 26 points alongside four rebounds. And then the hot hand, the quick release of Kayla McBride. She's 3 from 4 from downtown for her 14 points. Also has 5 rebounds and 3 assists. Mersin, well, they struggled in the first half just to hold on to the coattails of Fenerbahce. No player really establishing themselves in the game. You spoke to the coaches at the half. What's the vibe you get, particularly from Coach Iniguez? What do they do now?
Coach Iniguez wanted to say that it is really their responsibility as a team right now, players and coaches. And he was saying that obviously, you know, that Fenerbahce, when they are full speed, is difficult. But right now, they need to play for their own pride. They cannot be behind that much. So we should see a different face for Mersin in that second half.
And it's going to be interesting to see how they react. Some players, this motivates them and gives them steel to work harder in the second half. Other players, it might tip them over the emotional edge. There's certainly a lot of emotional players within that Mersin roster. How they react could dictate how this second half goes. As for Coach Malkovic, I heard your question, what can they do better? Simple answer, everything.
That sums up Coach Malkovic, right? I was sure she would say nothing for us, but she has, but she didn't.
No, wishful thinking. I think her players were thinking that as well. Maybe we've done enough. No, she wants 20 more minutes of world-class basketball, historic-level basketball. No, she's
sure
demanding.
And we see it in the first half. They were up 30, but they kept pressing Mersin, and they're going to come in the second half and do exactly the same thing, full court pressure. That's their DNA.
Yeah, I mean, you're exactly right. You look at the roster that Coach Malkovich has brought together. She's brought together those players that want that. They want someone saying them more, more. I don't care that we're up. I don't care that you're 100% from the field. I want more. She's brought together a roster that thrives in that kind of environment of trying to get to your ceiling, trying to get to the best you can possibly be in every aspect. And, you know, we've seen what that does in the first 20 minutes of this game. It does 57 points and holding the opponents to 24. So it certainly has had a positive effect on them. Seconds away from the start of the second half. Remember, a new name will go on the trophy at the end of today. It's looking like Fenerbahce have one hand on the trophy right now. Mersin will have to make a move here in the third quarter if they stand any chance of causing the upset. Second half action underway here in Prague, the final of the 2023 EuroLeague women's season. At the half, Fenerbahce lead this one 57-24 over Mersin. Williams now inside against Messerman. Quick hands by Emma Messerman. She read the spin from Williams perfectly.
One thing Coach Iniguez told them for sure is to put the ball inside and make the Fenerbahce post player work in defense.
Hayes now with possession, going up against McBride. High, arcing, snow, grabbing three, but it's an air ball from Tiffany Hayes. That is not what Mersin need in their opening offense of the second half. Vandersloot now just slides down the lane, hands it off to Messerman. Oh, that is beautiful offense. And there's so many little 1-2 combinations in this Fenerbahce team. It's so hard to lock out or overplay on anyone in particular.
You can tell how Vandersloot and Messerman have that connection, been playing together for a long time now.
Cornelius inside, draws the foul, I think from Vandersloot. And that was much better ball movement from Mersin. There was patience. Fenerbahce did a great job in rotating and recovering, but that was much better patient offense from Mersin. There's the foul by Vandersloot, and Cornelius will head to the line for shots. Cornelius Cornelius hits the first of her two. Just 4 points for Laura Cornelius in today's game. That's the second to go as well. Stewie now running the point guard position for Fenerbahce. Sabali for three. And this is what Fenerbahce do. There are so many threats across the floor. This time it's Sabali stepping in, draining the long shot.
I love how they're finishing them going under the screen.
Lovely play, beautiful pass. Chelsea Gray, point guard, doing what she does best, finding her teammates. Perfect precision on the pass, and McBride will get called for the foul, and Cornelius will have a chance of a three-point play. There's the Sabali three. What a semi-final Sabali had. 13 points, 5 rebounds over Skio, and for me, Sabali was the spark that restarted and got Fenerbahce on the right track in that semi-final.
Definitely, playing at the three like she is now, she has the advantage with her size and her athleticism.
And a sloop brings it up over the half, guarded closely by Cornelius. McBride, quick release, and another two. Kayla McBride, 16 points now.
Kayla McBride is probably one of the quickest release.
Double team comes up onto Gray, foul will be called. A little bit of an over-exuberance from Sabali and Messimum. Messimum, I think, will be called for that foul. Yeah, there's the double team. Yeah, a little bit too much pressure on Gray. Third foul, of the quarter for Fenerbahce. So a chance for Mersin maybe to pick their way back into this game from the free throw line. Hayes goes strong. Williams picks up the offensive rebound and just establishes herself well enough and quickly enough to get the score. And a sloop just finds a way in, can't get the score, does grab her own rebound though. Foul will be called. Let's see who that was on. There was a hustle for the rebound. One's on Gray, her first foul as she tries to fight for the rebound over the top of Vandersloot, but Vandersloot had that one locked in. Messimum now. Down in the low post. What a battle between Williams and Messimum. Williams called for the foul, her second of the game.
Mersin's trying to be a bit more aggressive in defense. For now, they're calling fouls, but that's what they have to do to be give nothing easy to Fenerbahce.
That's good defense from Servan Dakic in the low post against Stewart. Can only knock it out of bounds. That remains Fenerbahce ball, but that increased level of aggression could cause Coach Malkovich's teams some problems. Messimum now will hand it off to Vandersloot. Stewart is blocked. Great defense by Servan Dakic.
Great block by Servan Dakic.
This is the only way that Mersin are going to get back into this. It is going to be built on the defensive end. Shot clock down to 5. Cornelius uses the Williams screen. There's the roll. Williams will go inside. Nice soft left, right hand from Elizabeth Williams. That's a nice pick and roll executed perfectly by Mersin. Vandersloot wide open for three. It's off left though, clangs off the perspex. Messimum will go. She can't get it to fall either. Servan Dakic with her third rebound of the game. Great, gets into the paint at last, steps through but kicks it out. Three ball is up and it's good. Servan Dakic nails the three. There is life left in Mersin. There is life left in this final.
That's how they're going to come back with team actions.
Brianna Stewart now. Good rotation from Mersin. Sabali for three. Oh, that's a heartbreaker. So beautiful offense by Fenerbahce.
So unselfish. Because Kayla McBride could have taken that shot and she saw Sabali in the corner get the extra pass. So unselfish from her.
Gray now inside, double team comes across, Williams will put it up, Williams will rattle home another one, and whilst Mersin can keep this scoreboard ticking over, they still stand a chance of causing what would probably now be the greatest upset in the competition's history. Shot clock down to six, Van der Sloot lobs it into Stewart. Williams intercepts it, that's smart play. Hayes now puts the Jets on in transition, goes up against McBride, can't get the score. That's good defense by McBride. She continued to retreat, but kept the tempo and the pressure up. Sabali, easy of two in transition for Satu Sabali.
Get back in defense.
Mersin's transition defense just fell asleep that time. Eight left on the shot clock for Gray. What can she do? Little free throw line jumper. And we hear the whip of the net from our commentary position.
For sure, from now on, it's going to come from her. She can turn the game around and we need to do it now.
Amanda Sloot. Shot clock to eight. She'll put the three up. That one's short. Where's the rebound? Sabali. Servandakic going at it. Serbian comes away with a rebound and hands it to Gray. Gray with a double team, it's off a leg and it's a loose ball now. Messerman scoops it up and gives it to Van der Sloot. Hands it off to Stewart, who will not get the score but will head to the free throw line.
What happened when you turn the ball over against Fenerbahce?
As soon as you turn the ball over, there's just a huge yellow wave that pours down the court and really is unstoppable. We're going to see a double change here for Fenerbahce as Messerman and Van der Sloot go to the bench. Stokes and Chaka come on. Servandakic also takes a rest for Mersin. Into the game comes Dubljevic. Confusion at the moment. I think they've made a double change without the officials waving them on. I think we've clarified the situation, so I think we're heading to the free throw line for two free throws for Brianna Stewart. 26 points for Brianna Stewart today. Her season high was back on game day 9, 30 points and 17 rebounds. I have a feeling that she is going to top that 30-point haul from game day 9. Yeah. That one was against Zexard. And Mersin potentially are going to be on the end of her biggest night of the year. And what a time to save it up for the final. She misses the second, though. So her tally will stay at 27. Cornelius to Gray. Almost stolen by Sabali. Hayes is open for three. It's off left, though. Stewart with another rebound. Her fifth of the game. Inside to Sabali. She's got the size advantage over Hayes. The double team drops on her, so she comes out. Chaka, a little flat. Where's the rebound fall? It falls into the hands of Cornelius for Mersin. Hayes for three. Not this time. Stokes with the rebound.
Getting open looks, not getting in, but Hayes, I think she'll get back her confidence by continuing to drive the ball and go to the lane.
Sabali spins into the lane. Gray with great defensive footwork. Shot clock down to five. Wide open. Chaka for three. It's way off right, though. It's off the legs of Williams. But there'll only be 0.4 seconds left on the shot clock. The Coach Inagez will be happy. He asked for his team to show a bit of steel, a bit of guile, and a bit of personality in this third quarter. They've outscored Fenerbahce 16-13 in this quarter. And those are the kind of little victories that I'm sure Coach Inagez will be trying to get his team to build on.
Yeah, you can't control if you're going to make the basket or not, but what you can control is the way you put defense, the intensity you put, and right now they're showing a different fence that they showed in the first half.
Offensive foul has been called on Kayla McBride for just pushing a hip out on that screen. That's her third foul of the game. That will send her to the bench, and Van der Sloot comes back in, and you can see the smile on the Fenerbahce players' faces. Every time one of their teammates gets a foul, they quite like it because it means they get back into the game. Courtney was more than happy to see McBride pick up the foul so she could get back on the floor and enjoy this final. Galton now on the ball. Williams sets the screen for her. Doesn't create the mismatch they wanted, though. Bublovic fakes, drives the baseline, hands it off. That's good defense from Stokes, but there's a foul called as the slashing Williams gets caught in the face by Stokes. Much better offense there by Mersin. They read the floor a lot better, and selfless pay by the veteran Bublovic.
Yeah, Fenerbahce has been closing the paint all night. Every time somebody's going to drive in the paint, they're going to close and they will find the open person.
Yeah, Williams comes up short again. She's 0-3 from the free throw line this evening. It is one of the, well, probably the weakness in her game, to be fair. Just 50% this season. Yeah, even then she pulls at it. Had some off-season hours in the gym for Elizabeth Williams. Chaka now hands it off to Van der Sloot. Oh, and Stokes had gone a little early. Hayes now in transition against Sabaly. Does a great job, but can't draw the foul. Travelling violation, though, called on Tiffany Hayes. Sabaly will now go to the bench, and Brianna Stewart comes back on. This is just a carousel of world-class, future Hall of Fame superstars that Fenerbahce keep rolling onto the floor. Sloot now finds Stewart. Stewart hands it straight back to her. Chaka will drive the baseline to Yagapova. Wow. This is beautiful offense, selfless offense. Chaka will take the jumper, and that kind of offense deserves a finish.
Beautiful.
Such patience, such fluidity, great spacing. Just, yeah, real textbook basketball being played by Fenerbahce right now.
Playing really unselfish.
Great. Trying to create for her teammates, but Yagapova is all over. Hands it off to Williams, though. Kelsey Gray is trying to do what she can. That's her sixth assist of the game. That's a backcourt violation called on Fenerbahce. Courtney Van der Sloot and Brianna Stewart look slightly confused. And as it stands, Fenerbahce have a 30-point lead here in the final with 1:09 remaining in this third quarter. Mersin ball, Gray now, going up against Yagapova again. Behind the back to Yalchin. She drives inside against Van der Sloot. What a play!
Great take.
That's a brave move. The veteran point guard getting in amongst the trees to get the score. And a salute to Chaka, to Stokes. Again, beautiful movement of the ball for Fenerbahce. Chaka will take it. Chaka is having a night of her own right. 8 points now for Fenerbahce's captain.
She has the hot hands right now.
Fenerbahce fans have been in fine voice from the opening tip, and it just seems to get louder and louder as the game progresses, as they get closer to lifting that trophy for the first time. Stewart with another rebound, that's her sixth. 3 seconds left in the quarter. Chaka kicks it out. Yagapova wide open, nails the shot to kill the quarter. And that sums up Fenerbahce here today. Clinical in execution as they are now just 10 minutes away from potentially lifting their first ever EuroLeague Women's Trophy. There's the jumper from Yagapova, the assist from Chaka. See what it means to Olcay Chaka. That's why she's captain of this team. Her hands are held high and she screams to the sky on the score. A 33-point lead with 10 minutes still to play. What a game from Fenerbahce.
Honestly, it looks close to perfection for Fenerbahce tonight. They've been just unbelievable. 58% on the 3 points. Just one of those nights. They're playing really good. They are dominating the rebound, 32-19. And they're playing so unselfishly, 19 assists. And it's only the third quarter, still one quarter in that game. Just doing everything tonight.
Yeah, it's been unbelievable. And they have been led, unsurprisingly, by Brianna Stewart. She has 27.6 rebounds, 2 assists. And she is close to having the all-time scoring record in a final. Currently held by, well, Dana Taurasi, 31 points back in 2009. Is the target for Brianna Stewart. She's only 5 points away from setting the record. She's got 10 minutes to go. I think we are in for a historic performance from Brianna Stewart. What an amazing night this has been for her. However, Mersin still have a quarter to go. The chances are exceptionally slim, but Coach Iniguez will not let them back down. He will demand 10 minutes where they express themselves and show the basketball world what Mersin basketball is about. Because for Coach Iniguez, he laid this out at before the start of the tournament. This isn't just about this year. Yeah. This is year one of many years that they want to be at this Final Four.
Yeah, like you said, they're not just here to play. They want to compete. Tonight is not going how they want, but they will fight until the end, that's for sure.
And a salute now. Looking for options. Goes to Chaka. It's almost stolen away. And Cornelius really showing us how much hustle and heart. Chaka with a little shake. The lane opens up and she gets barreled off the baseline. Dubljevic is frustrated again. She needs to be careful. Let's have a look at the replay. What about your left arm, I'm afraid? You've shoved her out the way. Yes, you may have got the ball with your right, but your left arm just edged her off the baseline.
That's a good call.
Chaka at the line for two. In and out of the rim. Olcay Chaka, one of those captains that doesn't necessarily get all the plaudits, particularly in a team full of so many superstars, but she is that kind of glue piece that keeps this team together, gives them an identity, gets them to understand when they arrive what Fenerbahce basketball means in the city and also to the fans that are in the stands.
Definitely, she was the starting point guard last season and now she's a backup, but sometimes she started the game like Friday and yesterday. This team is just, all the players can play and she's clearly the earl of this team and she's the captain and she's been in Fenerbahce for several years now, so if they win tonight, for sure for her, it will represent a lot.
Yeah, her second spell at Fenerbahce, she was there from 2010 to 2016, and then she came back in 2019. So yeah, she is one of the consistents. And I think for Fenerbahce in particular, more so than a lot of teams, it's important when the players arrive, they do understand the culture. It comes with a lot. You know, you hear some of the players laugh about it. You know, Emma Messman spoke about it in her speech, saying understanding what we mean, what the club means to the fans is just huge for them. Absolutely, it really is. As we see a foul called on Dubljevic. That will be her fifth foul and she's out of the game. She heads back to the bench and that's really been coming quite a while as Dubljevic has shown more and more that she's losing her patience with the game.
Yeah, unfortunately, especially in this kind of game, you don't need that.
Not at this point. Veteran players need to lead Mersin at the moment because it's about coming back bigger, better and stronger next season. Van der Sloot now using the Messerman screen. There's the lob pass to Messerman. Messerman just drops it off the back of Cornelius, so it will remain Fenerbahce ball. Fenerbahce fans, you feel, are starting to prime themselves for some celebrations. They're just away to the left of our commentary box, and it's an absolute sight to see when Fenerbahce fans are in full voice. Messerman, catch and shoot, no good. Rebound pulled down by Hollingsworth. Hollingsworth, third rebound of the game. Hollingsworth, a former Fenerbahce player, and she gets the score. Played there for 3 years, 2013-16. She's now on the other side of things and feeling the Fenerbahce wrath here tonight. Jakubova looking to the officials for the foul call, and Jakubova just rips the ball through, knowing that Hayes is going to get caught and called for the foul if she does. Sideline possession for Fenerbahce, and that puts Mersin into the penalty now. 8 minutes and 41 still to play. Expect quite a few free throws coming Fenerbahce's way. Here's Brianna Stewart. Feeted inside, Jakubova, selfless play yet again. Chaka goes baseline, fades away, puts a prayer up. The defense really was a match for that offense. Yalcin comes back out now. Zvandakic slows it and goes up against Messman. There's the shoulder shake inside, but the pass is poor to Hollingsworth.
See, that's difficult, all the how they stop the game. Especially, I don't think it's that big of a mismatch, Zvandakic against Messman.
No, I don't think she particularly has the foot speed that maybe she thinks she does over Messman. Messman reads the game so well that it helps for sure. Chaka slides inside, finger roll off the glass for two. And that's the captain in double digits. 11 points now for Chaka, 5 from 9 from the field. And a Sloot scoops up the steal, hands it off to Jakubova. They get the score. Fenerbahce's lead continues to grow here in the fourth quarter. Yeah. 37-point lead now for Fenerbahce. Cornelius to Hollingsworth, it's stolen away. Van der Sloot was looking for the transition, but
still is that?
Mersin closed the lanes off for her. Now to Stewart. Drives the baseline, spins inside, hands it off to Messerman. Messerman will get the score. 8 points now for Emma Messerman. And that is why this is such a great team. Brianna Stewart not looking for the score herself, trying to facilitate for her teammates. There's the steal from Jakubova. There's the pickup from Van der Sloot. Hands it back to Jakubova for the easy two off the glass. Jakubova now up to 5 points as well.
Double on her, but she still has the great look for Messerman. Unbelievable.
Just beautiful vision from Stewie. Timeout called. Let's listen to the huddle. Coach Iniguez trying to get his team to make the most of the final 7 minutes and 4 seconds. The game is slipping away from them for sure as we see some of the replays of the barrage of offense from Fenerbahce. Kayla McBride, 16 points, 4 assists, 6 rebounds. She didn't have the best of nights in the semi-final, but she's really stepped up the performance here this evening. But for Mersin, they have 7 minutes to really learn and gain some momentum now. Partly for their domestic season to conclude that, but also to build towards a campaign next year where they want to be back at the EuroLeague Women Final Fours. Stolen away, Chaka read the passing lane perfectly. In and out as Stewie has gone to the bench. In her place comes Georgievich, 24-year-old getting an experience of the finals. Didn't get any time in the semis, Onar puts up the long shot, ripped down by Servan Dakic, and Hayes is holding her face. Looks like she's picked up another injury. And this time maybe a poke to the eye. Chaka will go to the bench. Into the game comes Kayla McBride, and you wonder if Coach Malkovich would have Stewie on the floor if she knew how close she was to the all-time final scoring record. Sideline possession for Mersin. They get the action underway again into the hands of Gray. Little under 6.5 minutes to play. Hayes. Hesitation dribble goes up against Messerman. Messerman stays with it. Hollingsworth almost gets the rebound, but Yagapova rips it away from behind.
Like you said, it's really important for Mersin to stay in the game. They might face each other again this season in domestic league, so they need to, as difficult as it is, they need to keep working.
Yeah, you wonder what the damage could be done if they don't stay with it, if they don't feel, oh, what a big three from Chelsea Gray. And that's the kind of play they need to gain some momentum and confidence, but you wonder what damage could be done for the rest of their domestic season if they don't feel that they gave themselves a good account of themselves here in the final. Yagapova goes strong, gets another score. Yagapova's personal tally starting to creep up. She's up to 7. Gray now skips it round to Hayes. Hayes against McBride. As always, Fenerbahce's defense doesn't seem to have any weaknesses. Pass to Hollingsworth, short two, no good. Servan Dakic just reaches up high over the top of Georgievich to grab the O-board and put it back. Onar. My goodness me, that's some pace she took to the basket. Can't get the score. Ends up in a heap on the floor off the baseline. She's back on her feet and back in the defensive action. Gray. Looked like she pulled at that one, though. Foul will be called on Onar as she just pushes her way through. This is ending up on the floor. Another change for Fenerbahce as Yagapova goes to the bench, and into the game comes Aydin again. And Coach Malkovich now starting to give every player plenty of minutes on the floor to experience this final, to be a part of what looks like will be Fenerbahce's first ever title.
Almost all the players have been on the court.
Foul's going to be called as Gray was just helped off the sideline, I think is the polite way of putting it.
The pressure they keep putting on the ball. That's crazy. They win by almost 40 points, but they're still playing high-level defense.
And that's the Coach Malkovich way, right? That's what she was talking about. I want more. I want never better.
Never satisfied.
Nice pass inside. Oh, Laptopus can't get it to go, though. The Mersin captain seeing some first action of the final. And a jumper for Messerman is good. And if Chaka is the spiritual leader for Fenerbahce, you would certainly say that Uraltopus is for Mersin as well. She has a real cohesive nature. She tries to bring the team together, knit them together as one big family. Gray now turns the corner. Oh, the pass is whipped by Gray, but not quite enough. Around the corner to Natash. Another change, and Ratza will be into the game, and Stewie's back on the floor. Now, the record is back on the line.
Now all the Fenerbahce players have been on the court.
And that's great to see. All the way through, 1 through 12, every single Fenerbahce player has got to experience what looks like will be their first ever EuroLeague women's title, a moment in the club's history. Onar now. Stewie just asking for the ball. Gets it back to Onar. Onar skips through, floats up the right hander, my goodness. A huge amount of contact, stays with the play and gets the score. Onar getting her first bucket of the game.
But we're seeing no matter who's on the court,
Servan Dakic will put it up. Rebound pulled down, and Mersin continue to fight. Atash now with the three. Ural Topus fighting Stewart for the rebound, but Fenerbahce will hold on to it. A little over 3 minutes to play in this final. Stewie for three. Nails it! That's a huge shot from Stewie, and she has tied the record here in Prague. Any more scores from Brianna Stewart, and she will have the record. Most points scored in a EuroLeague women's final. The score is good for Atash. Stewie now.
Unbelievable.
Up to 31 points, level with Diana Taurasi for the record. Can Stewie break the record? It's in her hands. She's gonna back her way down. She puts a shot up. She'll go to the free throw line. Will she break the record from the free throw line? A treble change for Fenerbahce as Messerman, Sabali and Van der Sloot come in. Latza, Georgievich and Onar go to the bench, and this is almost turning into a little bit of a victory lap here for Fenerbahce as we see the Stewie three to tie the record. At the line, for the record, she's made it! Stewie is now the record holder. 32 points in a final. No one has scored as many points in a final as Brianna Stewart. And the second. If her legend wasn't cemented already, we have another stone in the wall of that legend today.
She's just amazing.
Absolutely iconic performance from Brianna Stewart. Stolen away, Aydin now, leading the break.
Makes everything.
Messerman inside, Sabali is blocked from behind but fouled. And that's good sportsmanship, that's what we like to see. Atash going over, helping her opponent up. You can be aggressive, you can play hard. Straight over, she's the first there to help her up. That will send Sabali to the line for two. Under 2 minutes left on the game clock now. The Fenerbahce fans are ready. They're on their feet, already in celebration mode. Sabali misses the first though. It's the second. What a game from Fenerbahce. This is one that will go down in the history books for Fenerbahce. Not just the fact that it was their first ever title, but the way they've played this game. They have really sent out a message of exactly how good they are this year. Now it's down to the organization to try and bring these pieces back again next year.
Yeah.
Potentially easier said than done.
What I'm thinking as well, is it the beginning of a...
Could this be a dynasty?
Yeah.
Wow. Cornelius now receives the inbound. Trying to get to the basket. Not an easy task against Van der Sloot. Atash goes inside. That's a smart play from the 28-year-old. Just cuts through the paint to find some space. And there isn't much space when you're playing Fenerbahce in this form. Sabali now. Inside. Gets the shot away, and another 2 points for Brianna Stewart. She's making that record almost unbeatable right now. She's up to 35 points on the night.
We're lucky to witness her.
And that one spilled out of bounds. Another good deflection by Van der Sloot as Sabali calls for the Fenerbahce fans to be a little bit louder. They don't need telling twice. About to enter the final minute of this final. And the Fenerbahce bench are on their feet. You can't see them on your screen, but they are bouncing along with the fans. Stewie now, long two. Short this time. I think they'll let her off, though. Rebound pulled down by Cornelius. Brought up over the half by Fituk. She tries to go all the way, kicks it out. Shot goes up, and it's good. And you have to like this for Coach Inagez and his team. They have fought, they have put the fight into this second half. They have given everything they've got Fenerbahce have just been too much.
Playing into the very end for Mersin.
Final 30 seconds of the game. Cornelius almost has it stolen away by Messerman. She'll back out. She's got the mismatch she wants. She'll back out again. 9 left on the shot clock. Pulls up. Elbow jumper. Foul going to be called as Messerman catches her wrist. Look at the celebrations on the bench. You can see how much it means. A lot of the staff involved have been there a while. They've been through the heartache. And now they get the joy. And you can see the little wry smile on Coach Malkovich's face. It's going to be an interesting interview after the game, an interesting press conference to see how Malkovich is about this win, this historic win.
I think Fenerbahce fans are ready to go on the court. Security needs to be ready.
What a night for every Fenerbahce fan. Those in the arena here, those back home watching, tuning in. A huge night. 12 seconds left before Fenerbahce secure this historic moment, and what a moment it will be. They're going to play it out, the final 3 seconds. What a moment for Fenerbahce basketball. It's all over, and our 2023 EuroLeague Women Champions are Fenerbahce. The wait is over. Redemption is complete. Fenerbahce have won it all. They are crowned champions of Europe. Celebrations begin in the stands, celebrations begin on the floor, rightfully so. The ghosts of the past have been put to bed for Fenerbahce. They are European champions for the first time in their history. What an achievement for that team.
They didn't only win, they made a statement tonight. What a performance by Fenerbahce.
So many emotions on show, unbelievable emotions on show, and understandably so. These players have put everything into this season. They may have been considered to be the big favourites, but to convert that is another thing. And that's exactly what they've done today. They've taken all the potential, they've put it on the floor, and they've come away with the trophy. And look at Coach Malkovich. She doesn't show a huge amount of emotion, but you can just feel the pride she has for her team. She's left them to celebrate on the floor. She's stayed by the bench to celebrate with her staff. Look at the emotion from the players. This isn't just about what they've put in this season. This is about the careers that they have built towards these kind of moments. Emma Messerman announced as the regular season MVP at the ceremony yesterday. We'll find out who the finals MVP is shortly. The Mersin players go over to congratulate the Fenerbahce players, and that is a wonderful sight. Two Turkish teams, and obviously Turkey as a country has had a difficult year this year, to say the least, and the emotions that have built up and the challenges that that country and these two teams and their communities have faced, they come together for an all-Turkish EuroLeague women's final. And now the Fenerbahce fans will come over, sorry, the Fenerbahce players will come over to the fans and celebrate with them. Captain Olcay Çakır leading the dancing for sure. What a moment for all of these players in their careers. These are the moments that they worked so hard for. These are the moments that they will remember forever, as they come together as a team to achieve a moment in history for Fenerbahce. Huge performances across the roster from our newly crowned champions. None more so than record-breaking Brianna Stewart. 35 points. She is the record holder now for most points scored in a EuroLeague women's final. 35 points, 6 rebounds, 3 assists and 2 steals was her stat line. Kayla McBride had 16 points, 6 rebounds, 5 assists. Satu Sabali with 11 points, 4 rebounds, and Emma Messerman with 10 points and 7 rebounds. But it really is about the team, not the individuals today. That's what's got them here. That's what's got them to the top of the podium. And now they will celebrate long into the night here in Prague. There are tears on the floor. There are your shooting stats, but I'm not sure that any of the coaches will be looking at those. They will just be looking at the emotion. Xhaka now in front of me, coming over to the fans. And she gives all the fans a round of applause. She embraces right at the front of the stand. We'll now jump to some of the highlights from today's game while we get the preparations in the arena for the medals and trophy presentation. That's what they've been playing for, that trophy. Here are some of the highlights from today's games. We'll be back shortly with all of the trophy presentation here in Prague. Welcome back to the celebrations here in Prague, and we're going to see a touching moment now as Brianna Stewart embraces with her partner Marta and also with her daughter Ruby, who, to be honest, has stolen the show so many times across this weekend, it's untrue. But what a day for Fenerbahce basketball. What a moment in this club's history, winning their first ever EuroLeague women's title. The fans are in the stands, and I think they are going to be here for a very, very long time as they cheer this team on. And rightfully so, they have put so much into winning this title. And they've written their names into the history books, not just for the club, but for Turkish basketball and the entire competition. What a final we have witnessed. Final score here in Prague is 99 to Fenerbahce Mersin with 60. Fenerbahce have claimed their first title in style. That's the trophy. That is what they have worked so hard for. That is what they have put blood, sweat and tears onto the hardwood floor for. They had a shaky start to the season, lost their first couple of games, but it has been all meteoric rise from there on, finishing the season without losing a game since those opening two games. The players now. And Chaco at the moment just practicing her trophy lift, I think. She's just checking with her teammates how many swings she should do before she lifts it. Certainly an amazing moment for all of these players, and Coach Malkovic has done a phenomenal job bringing together a roster that everyone touted as being the favourites, but sometimes it's difficult to get so many superstars pointing in the same direction, but Coach Malkovic has achieved it, and now that is their prize. That is what they get to take back to Istanbul on the plane tomorrow with them. And the fans and the players have such a symbiotic relationship in Fenerbahce. One doesn't go without the other. The fans have lifted them up.
Congratulations. What a game, what a performance. It's your first year here in Fenerbahce, but after all this year they've been chasing the EuroLeague title, you finally made it. How does it feel?
Yeah, I mean, it's always, the first one's always really exciting, and I'm glad we could get it done for the Fenerbahce club, the fans, everything. I mean, you see everybody that shows up, the energy and the love they have for this team and this club. You know, it's really, really special, and you know, it's like we work all season for this, and for them to be able to come out and support us and us to get it done here, it feels like our home floor, so it's nice.
Can we say it's the beginning of a long streak?
The beginning of a long what?
Of a long streak.
You know, it's tough to be champions. It's really hard, but this club is always in the running, and I'm sure they would love to see a streak.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Courtney van der Sloot there, absolutely integral to Fenerbahce walking away with the trophy. Had a slightly quieter game today, but she was so instrumental in that semi-final. The facilitator that she is. And that is the strength of this Fenerbahce team. There are so many world-class superstars who put in big performances game after game after game. We are now moments away from the presentation of both the silver medals, the gold medals, the MVP award, and of course, the trophy as well. So don't go anywhere. That will be coming up very, very shortly. But you can see what it means to not just the players, but so many of the staff involved with the Fenerbahce club. It's in your DNA if you work for the club, and it means so much for them to come away with the trophy. So much heartbreak last year. They thought it was their year on their home court. Losing to Sopron that way really did cause so much heartbreak, but Olcay Çakır talked about it in the pre-Final Four press conference. It has changed them, but in a good way. That was her quote. It has had an effect on them, that loss last year, but in a good way. And I think we can all see what she means right now. This is the good way. They have refocused, rebuilt, and they are ready to go again and fight for this title. What an unbelievable performance from Fenerbahce. We are now just getting into the final preparations. The Fenerbahce fans are going nowhere. They are on their feet in the stands as they have been for pretty much the entire game. The Fenerbahce players will now just briefly head back to the locker room for them to be reintroduced as European champions. Atmosphere here in Prague has been phenomenal. The city has provided a wonderful backdrop to what has been an amazing climax of this season. One of the most competitive, one of the most dramatic EuroLeague women's seasons we've ever had. And what an amazing final to finish it off with. Absolutely storybook across the board. Earlier today, we saw Skio in their first Final Fours upset Praha on their home floor. Skio going home with the bronze medal. Mersin in their first ever appearance at the Final Fours as well, going home with the silver medal. And Fenerbahce picking up their first ever title. What an amazing Final Fours we've had here. It really has delivered on all fronts, some of the best basketball you could ever imagine to see. Coach Malkovich, if you can just see at the bottom of your screens now, in an embrace, celebrating this achievement. But what an achievement it is to be the coach, to bring Fenerbahce their first ever title. I'm sure she'll earn the key to the city of Istanbul for this achievement alone, let alone all of the other achievements she's had. Unbelievable for this club. We will now have the presentations for the silver medals. Our presentation party for the silver medals are Carmen Takala, who is a FIBA Europe Vice President, and Carl Thaler, who is FIBA Europe Treasurer. And Mersin will now come and collect their silver medals, and it's bittersweet. They must look on the bright side of this and the positivity of what they have achieved. A phenomenal season. Just to get to the Final Four after the turbulent start is an amazing achievement, and it won't quite feel that way at the moment. They come to the floor to collect their silver medals. So many big performances across the season. It is going to be tough to keep the disappointment down as they come to the floor. The Alcian, Takmaz, Dublovic, Cornelius, Vituk, Natash, Williams, Gray, Hollingsworth, Hayes, Savendikic, Ural Topas, the captain at the end there, collecting her silver medal. And Coach Iniguez following them all. And you do wonder, can Mersin keep this team together for next season? If they can, the experience of today, the experience of this Final Fours will really help them. They have certainly done themselves proud. I'm sure they would have wanted a closer final, but they have given absolutely everything this season. And they are receiving appreciation across the floor, including the Fenerbahce fans who are here as well, showing their appreciation for their fellow Turkish side, Mersin. As the staff now come up onto the podium with them, and that's the key. So many people have to pull together in the same direction for a team to get to this level, and that's what Mersin have done. They are our 2023 runners-up, and we have to give them a huge amount of credit for what they've achieved this season. Coach Iniguez came in the mid-season, really turned around their fortunes, pointed them in the right direction, brought them together as a team. And what achievements they have had here. They walk away runners-up in their first ever Final Fours. They should be super proud of all they have achieved this season. But Coach Iniguez talked about it. This is going to be one of many. This is them pushing towards a regular at the Final Fours. That's what he's asking. That's what he's demanding of the organization and the players that represent the organization. We will now have a short break whilst we get ready to receive our European champions, our 2023 EuroLeague Women Champions, Fenerbahce.
Ladies and gentlemen, we present the champions of the EuroLeague Women Final Four 2023. And the medals for the champions are presented by FIBA.
Our presentation party for the gold medals is the FIBA Secretary General, Andreas Zaglis, and Jean-Pierre Soutat, who is the FIBA Europe Vice President.
Please give a big round of applause for the winning team of Fenerbahce Alagoz.
Here come our champions. And the noise levels increase as the Fenerbahce fans let them hear it. First out is Satu Sabali as she bounces onto the floor. Crowned a European champion. And the fans show their appreciation. And Satu has gone straight to the podium without picking up a medal. She'll have to go back and pick it up. Djordjevic gets hers. Olcay Çaka, the captain, picks up her medal. Steps through Onar, and every single one of these players has put in a shift. Emma Messerman, regular season MVP. What a Final Fours for her. Unbelievable, really. Look at the relief as the players get to the podium. They get to stand on that top step. They get those gold medals. Kayla McBride, what a final for her. Another big performance. Courtney Vandersloot adds another chapter to her legendary status, as does Nina Yagapova. She continues to add more and more honours on that list. Brianna Stewart, the record holder, most points in a EuroLeague women's final, steps to court. Aydin now steps through as well. Kia Stokes, she came in and did a big job in the final. And then you have Coach Malkovic, the mastermind, the guru that sits behind it all and has created, well, one of the greatest teams in the history of the competition. And one of the greatest 40 minutes of basketball in a final that we have seen in a long while. That's the trophy. That's what they've been working for. The gold medals and the trophy. We'll now have the MVP presentation. Presentation will take place for the MVP trophy, and that will be presented by FIBA Executive Director Europe, Kamil Novak. I'm not too sure you'll win any prizes for guessing who will be the MVP. Surely it can only be one person. If you break a record in a final, surely that makes you the MVP. But let's wait and see. No surprises, Brianna Stewart is this year's MVP. What a performance from Brianna Stewart. 35 points, 6 rebounds, 3 assists and 2 steals. She now holds the record for most points scored in a EuroLeague women's final. What a game she has had. What a season she has had at Fenerbahce. Rightfully, deservedly receiving the MVP award. We will now move to the moment that so many Fenerbahce fans have been waiting for so many years, the trophy presentation. This will be presented by FIBA Europe President Turgay Demirel. And to collect the trophy will be Fenerbahce's captain, a spiritual leader, Olcay Çaka. She steps forward. And this is the moment that she has been waiting so long for. We go, the swing, to and fro and up. Fenerbahce are your 2023 EuroLeague women champions. They are history makers here in Prague. Olcay Çaka, the club captain, lifts the trophy to the sky. The emotions pour out, the fans on their feet, and see what it means to her. That is what we are here for. That is why we love this game so much. EuroLeague women's season has been absolutely phenomenal from start to finish. An absolutely storybook season. And the ending of the story is Fenerbahce lifting their first ever EuroLeague women's title. Everyone wants their piece of the trophy right now. These photos will be all over social media for the coming weeks. Look at that team, take a picture, remember it. History makers here in Prague. Fenerbahce securing their first ever EuroLeague women's trophy. And Glitter Cannon comes to an end, but the celebrations will just begin. Fenerbahce players continue to enjoy themselves on the midcourt. Final score here in the final. Just a reminder, Fenerbahce 99, Mersin 60. Fenerbahce pick up their first ever EuroLeague women's title. It's been so many years in the waiting for them. The celebrations will go long into the night. You've enjoyed the coverage as much as we have. An amazing season, an amazing climax to the season. And I don't know about you guys, but it's got me already wanting next season to be just around the corner. I'm not sure I can wait. Almost 6 months until the start of the next season, but I'm going to have to. But if it's even half as good as this season has been, it will be an amazing season next year. But there are our champions for 2023. Fenerbahce.